This conference will now be recorded.
Yes. Okay. The version control system. Okay, this is the first part of our DevOps life cycle. In our DevOps life cycle, we have a continuous development, we have a continuous compilation, and we have a continuous integration and continuous testing, continuous deployment, and in continuous monitoring. So this is the activity. Start from development up to the deployment, everything is automated. Okay, and that is DevOps. The role of DevOps engineer is to do this thing automated. So development will be taken care of by the developer. Okay, so the compilation and integration here too. During compilation also we perform a unit test, and then that test related activity will be taken care of by the testers. They define the test cases according to our requirement, and they do the testing. After that, the developer need to do the compilation of the individual programs, and after perfect compilation, those programs need to be integrated as a single entity, that is CA. Here too, after that we need to perform performance testing, we need to perform load testing as an integrated entity, as a fully developed integrated entity. We need to develop these sort of testings, performance load testings, once again done by several tools and by testers. And after that, this part will be taken care of by the operation team, continuous deployment. So for continuous deployment, we need an infrastructure. We have already developed the package in our hand. The package need to be configured on the infra. Okay, the infra that we need to set up is servers. We need to set up database related things. We need to set up a storage associated with our application system, data storage requirement. These are all the things done by the operation team. So here these things can be automated by using CM tools, configuration management tools. Okay. We have the Jeffs or Puffert. These are all the tools which is used to create this configuration. Okay. So here after that it will be got deployed. The entire application will be got deployed here. That is continuous deployment. After that, if it is running it here in the production environment, it will be continuously monitored once again for its services, for its functionalities, whether it can able to withstand the high load. That is to ensure high availability, we need to do continuous monitoring. In each and every phase, we have a feedback, and the feedback will be given to the appropriate developer who develop the model. So this is the workflow. Here we have started with this version control system, which is used in a continuous development. Okay. So here the version control system's intention is to keep the source code. Whenever the source code developed by the developer is subjected to changes over that time, and along with this the current change, the previous version also will be retained. So what is the reason behind the change is done? Who did the change? When the change has been done, everything will be here. Everything will be need to be managed. The reason behind that is, so if a developer does a mistake and if they want to get back to the original previously committed version, being it is managed as a version, we can get it. Okay, so the version control software, the main functionality is keep track of every modification that we made in a code. Okay, so with respect to this version control system, so here we have the following types. We have two types of version control system. One is a distributed version control system, another one is a centralized version control system. Here, the difference between distributed and centralized version control system is, distributed version control system, all the informations associated with the particular software project code will be managed on a central server. And each and every developer's desktop, so here the entire information need to be fetched, and here they need to work with those informations. Okay, so at any point of time, the developer machine need a connection to the central server. If the connection is terminated, then the developer couldn't do any action, any activity. Why so? Because every information speaking is managed at the central server. That is centralized version control system. Whereas in case of a distributed version control system, here we have a central repository, we have a central server, and we have multiple developers associated with the project. What are all the files that is associated with the project? Let me take that it is a banking project. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 files. All the 4 files which is present in this central server will also stored on the developer's machine. All the developer machine contain all the files that is associated with the project. So at any point of time, the developer can do the needed references from its machine itself. We no need to go up with the correcting the central machine to get the needed references. Therefore, even though if there is a problem, the connection problem between this developer machine and the central server, the developer no need to wait to resolve the problem. He can do his activity on his machine, and after the connection is established, what are all the things that it is done on the developer machine can be pushed back to the central server. So these are all the some of the advantages in going for this distributed version control system. Okay, so here the version control systems helps individuals working with the projects keep tracking every individual change that done by the developer, and here help here when the change has been done and what is the reason behind the change, everything will be recorded here. Okay. So this is the way by which we make use of this version control system. Here in our session, we are going to make use of a distributed version control system called Git. Git is a tool which is used to do this version controlling, and all the information, if it need to maintain in a public repository, we use a repository called GitHub. These are all the two things associated. So similar to that of GitHub, we have several things. We have an Atlassian product. Okay, so here we will be dealing with Git and GitHub. Yes, so Git is a distributed version control system which is used to maintain the source code along with its history of changes that it is made. And the Git was developed by Linux Torvalds, who developed the Linux in the year 2005 or 2006, I think so. Okay. So here now it is one of the most widely used version control system tools. Okay, so these are all the things that it is discussed so far. With respect to this flow, Git, here we have the following architecture. So we have repositories with respect to Git workflow. We have repositories which is used to store all the details. With respect to repositories, we have local repository and we have remote or global repository. So here in the developer's machine, we have these components. We already discussed, just recall. We have workspace, we have staging area, and we have local repository. Okay, a developer develops the code. Here, let me take that program by name 1.java containing some lines of coding has been developed. The developer develops the code in its workspace. Then after that, he moves the code into the staging area. In the staging area, it will be taken a backup. A backup that it will be taken is incremental backup. Okay, it won't take a full backup. It will take an incremental backup. So here, because of it, we call Git as a lightweight component. Since it doesn't occupy more storage space, we call Git as a lightweight component. So from staging area, it will be moved into the local repository. And from the local repository, this is a remote or public repository, usually it will be GitHub. Okay. So here in our practice, we are simulating the GitHub. So here we have created a repository by name central.a.git. So this is assumed to be a simulation for the GitHub. Okay. So workspace, staging area, local repository. From local repository, we can move it into the central repository. Okay. So if it is moved into the central repository, repository can be configured under two categories. One is a bare repository and a non-bare repository. So here, what is the difference between this bare repository and non-bare repository? Here, the bare repository, we can store, we can share. Here in non-bare, we can store, we can share, and we can modify the file which is stored here. So therefore, the repository centrala.git has been configured as a bare repository, since it is used for storing and sharing the files associated with the project. So nobody will do modification in the centrala.git. Simply serves as a storage purpose and to share the files among all the developers associated with the projects. Whereas the repository, local repository that we use here is configured as a non-bare repository. So these are all some of the things that it is associated with, the bare and non-bare repository. So that while configuring this git, we use the command git init. It will configure as a non-bare. Git init -- bare instance, it will configure the repository as a non-bare repository. Okay, so that the respect to this command associated. So here from workspace, if you want to move to the staging area, the command is git add file name. Okay. And the file, if it moves from staging area into the repository, the command that we have discussed is git commit. So git commit, the commit need to contain as some commit message using this option. So this message will contain the reason. What is the reason behind the change has been made? If you have inserted a line or if you have removed a line, then what is the reason behind that particular change has been done, need to be given under the commit message. Okay. Once it is committed, the date and time along with this commit message, then along with the user who did the commit, everything will be recorded. And those informations we can able to view using the following command. Okay, you can use your command git log. This command will give you all the needed informations. Okay, also with respect to this file's status, we have the following status. File can be entered with the following status. The file can be initially, so imagine this is the developer machine. Here in this, the file is in the workspace, staging area, and in local repository. When the file is first time is created in the workspace, then it won't have a copy into the local repository. Therefore, at that time, the file's status is a new file. New untracked file. Which is because the status is not known to the local repository. When it is moved into the staging area, it will become a new file. Here, the color of the file, if you type this git status, the file will be listed as a new file, untracked file with the red color. Where when it is moved to the staging area, the color will move into the green color. New file, green color. If it is in the local repository, if the file is present in both local repository and in workspace, now it is a tracked file. Okay. If the content of the file is same in the workspace and local repository, if the content is same, then it is called unmodified file. If the content of workspace is not equal to content in the local repository, then the file is modified file. Okay, so these are all the status. New and untracked, new file, and then tracked file here. The file is under the modified status, the new file modified. Why is it? Because so now the content is not same in workspace and local. Now when we have the content in workspace and local, it is called track and unmodified. And these are all the file status. Please make a note. This question was asked in an interview. What is the workflow associated with the file status when it is moved from workspace into the local repository? placemaking.
File status.
Okay. So here, if you want to set up a repository, so here there are several ways by which we can set up a repository. What is a git init command? Another one is a git clone command. Another one is git config command. These are all the three ways by which you can create a repository. Okay. So now, this git init is used to create a new repository. It will create a new repository. The command is either you issue git init, if you issue this git init, it will create a non-bare repository. If you want to create a bare repository, git init hyphen hyphen bare. Okay, it will create a bare repository. So you have already a repository. You want to create another repository from an existing repository, means you want to issue a git clone. Okay, the command git clone the repository. Which repository that you need? For example, see here under ROM, we have a repository by name centrala.git. Okay, so if you want to clone it, here repository, let me make it as workspace one. Then what are all the content that it is present in centrala.git will be cloned to the repository workspace one. Okay, this is the way by which we can create a repository and copy the content of the repository based upon which we have created into the new repository, git clone. Okay, so here if you want this configuration for the remote collaboration, so here you have this developer's local repository. If it need to be configured with GitHub, okay, for collaboration between this developer machine and the GitHub public repository, we need to go for git config. Okay, so I will let you know the git config command at the time of discussion of GitHub. So these are all the ways by which we can work with this creating a repository. Okay, so let me do this practical. We have already, these are all the things that we have discussed so far. Okay, if you have any doubt with respect to this, kindly let me know before.
This conference will now be recorded.
You listen and you gather the information. What it is for. Okay, I am not asking you to do entire thing. Just the information, the sample example that I am giving. Notes will give you what is git init, what is a bare repository, those sort of informations. The scenario can be brought into notes, that's the reason. The scenario are currently rising in my mind. It is normally a good practice whenever you attend any seminars, whenever you attend any classes. What are all the key things that has been conveyed can be caught at a note, so that it will be easy for you to recall. It is up to your choice. If you don't want, you can listen, that's all. You can go through the video and you can get the hints from those videos. Now, we have created a ROM. What we are going to do? We are going to create, this is the scenario, we are going to create a file under the ROM repo and we are going to commit the file. Then after that, we are going to push the file into the centralA.git. This is the activity that we are going to do first. We are going to create a file by name on.java. So it is for sample. The file will be a real file. If it is a real file, it contains the all the associated codings. Okay. For our example, here we have on.java, and we are going to look into this git logs, and we are going to look into the status of the file, git status, all the associated commands. Then after that, now the file is moved from the repository, push the file from the repository RAM repo into the centralA.git. Okay, and here once it is pushed, here in the centralA.git, if you issue this git log command, it will give the all the log informations that it is present. What are all the log that it is present in RAM repo will be here. Okay, so just this is the scenario that we are going to do. Let I create a file here first. Now you ensure that please currently you are under the RAM repository by typing present working directory. The present working directory shows you are under I git new the centralA.git RAM repo. Okay, so this is the repository. Now if you type ls, there is no file. If you type git log, git log also doesn't contain any commit. Yes, if you type git status, these are all the key commands. So you are currently under the branch master, and there is no commit yet on the branch master. You can find on branch master no commits yet, nothing to commit. This is the information that has been shown here. What we can do, let me create a file here. The command to create a file, so it is a touch cat anything. I am creating a file by name on.java, a Java file with the name that I make it more appropriately, file on.java. Okay, now I have created a file. If you type ls, the same ls, now you can find you created a file. If I issue git status, now it will give you the status of the file. Now you can find the file's status is an untracked file. Now the color of the listed file name is red in color. Okay. Now if you type this git log, there is no log yet. You can get the log if and only if you do a commit. Okay. Git status. Now the file is in which area? The local workspace area. Okay. If I want to move the file into the staging area, I want to issue git add file name fon.java. Git add file name will take the file from the local repository and it will move the file into the staging area. Now if you type git status, now you can find the status of the file. Now it is to be in a committed stage. Now it is a new file in a green color. Okay, earlier it was untracked file with red color. Once you moved the file into the staging area, now file becomes a new file. Okay, here from the staging area, if you want to move the file into the local repository, the command is, this is the activity that we have done so far. We have created this git file into the workspace. Okay, and we moved the file into the staging area. Now the file is fon.java from the workspace. Now it is present in the staging area, fon.java. Here it will be taken a backup. We call this backup as a snapshot here. It will take an incremental snapshot. Okay. So after that, if you want to move the file into the local repository, here you want to issue git commit. Git add will move from workspace into the staging area. Git commit will move from the staging area into the local repository. Okay, the command is git commit co mm it. I want to issue a commit message hyphen m. I can issue a abra file 1.java created. Okay, this is the commit message. Enter. Now you can find this information is a register one files with the zero insertion and zero deletion. We have not added any line or we have not removed any line. Okay, so a file is created. Now if you type the status of the file, git status, now you can find the status of the file is nothing. Also because it is committed. If you type git log, you can find the log information. Okay, the each and every commit will have a commit ID. Okay, and then now your head is currently pointed towards the master branch, and the author who did the commit is Raman GS and the mail ID, and the date and time of commit is Saturday July 8/23. Okay, these are all the informations that it is recorded. Then the file is created. So is it making sense now? Now this information what we did is present in the Raman repository. Please make a note. You want to be very careful here. All these things, what are all the activity that we did here, this activity has been done on the computer associated with the Raman. So here we have a workspace, staging area and local repositories. Real time we have a git public repository. That repository is GitHub. So instead of GitHub, here to simulate we have created a repository by name centrala.git to simulate this environment. Now what I am going to do, so here I am going to, now I have this file f1.java here. I am going to move the file from this repository to the centrala.git f1.java. Okay, so before you just take this, what I am going to do, I want you to take notes of this particular diagram to make you understand, to make you clear. If you laterally go for reference, it will be clear for you what you did so far. That is the reason why I am requesting. To take this, what we are going to do. Then it is time to clear your doubts before doing the practical. You can, if you have any doubt, please let me know.
This conference will now be recorded.
We can.
This conference will now be recorded.
So now we are going to remove this file 1.java that we have created in central into the central A dot. From the we have created this in the assume developer ROMs machine. We have f1.java. Here we have a repository called centrala.git. Here we are going to move this file f1.java here and do the verification. And laterally, we will be creating another repository. Let me take this as a JP developer. A JP repository. So here this JP repository can be created using a git clone command. Okay, so here the source we can take it either a source of central data real time. In real time, you when a new developer had a entry into the project, and if we need a repository, the repository need to be cloned from the central repository. So here this is also possible. Here if you want to clone, if JP want to clone from a Raman's repository, yes, that is also possible. If not, JP can clone from the central repository. Both the repository, both the option is possible. So here in this case, if JP has created a repository based upon the central, then the central will be the parent repository for JP. If not, if JP has created a repository based upon this Raman, then the Raman will be the Raman repository will be parent to the JP repository. So here let me assume. So Raman repository containing f1.java. The central repository here contains f2.java. So based upon the Raman, if JP has created a repository and JP is already being the repository is created from Raman, the JP repository will have f1.java. The JP repository will have f1.java, is it? f1.java. Here in this case, if a JP created a f2.java, okay. So if you issue a git push command, where it will be pushed? Whether it will be pushed to the central or it will be pushed to Raman. Git push command, when you issue this git push command from the local repository, it will push the command to the parent repository only from which it is created. So by default, each and every repository is created from the central repository. The central repository will act as a parent repository. Okay. That is by the default. If you have created, for example, the repository of JP, if it is created based upon the Raman repository, then if JP issue a git push command, here this f2.java file that it is created will be moved into the parent repository. In this case, Raman repository is the parent repository, therefore it will be moved to here. If not, if the parent repository is created based upon this central, in this case it will move f2.java. If you issue git push, it will move to the location. So please make a note, it is not mandatory that you can clone a new repository based only on a central repository. The thing I want to make you convey here is also from another user's repository also you can create your own cloned repository. Yes? Is it making sense what I am trying to convey? Take this scenario along with this diagram so that you can have an understanding. You can create a new repository in two ways. One, either from a central, that is a global repository, or from other users' repository. Based upon which repository that you are created, for the created repository, that repository will act as a parent repository. Now what we are going to do? We are connected with Ram repository where we have f1.java. Okay, now first step, I am going to push this f1.java from Ram's repository into the central repository and do a verification whether it is successfully pushed or not. And laterally, let me create a new repository called a JP repository based upon a central repository and do this verification. Yes, this is the flow of the next 5 minutes of our practicals. Please make a note the scenario what we are going to do and kindly observe what it is going on. Laterally you can practice the same. I give you a minute or two to take a hint of this. After that I do the practical. Yes, shall I proceed? Okay. Now where we are currently? Currently we are under the RAM repository. Okay. So let me verify here. Let me git log. It will give you a log. I am moving back to central repository cd dot dot. Now I moved back to central repository. My present working directory is central repository. Here I am issuing the same log, git log. Now the master does not have any commit. Yes. So what I am going to do? I am going to move into the RAM repository. CD RAM repo. Okay. From the RAM repo, I am going to issue the push command. Once I issue the push command, now we can find file f1.java here. The file f1.java, as of the file, it won't move to the central. It will move along with the metadata information. Therefore, when it is moved, if you look to the central a.git and if you type ls here, okay, it won't list f1.java. Please make a note. The file f1.java, as a file, it won't move. It will move that associated metadata information into the central a.git. Okay, it won't show. Now you can find ls command under central a.git. It is not showing any file here. After moving also, it will show the same content. It won't list any file here. Now move to the RAM repo. Okay, so here I issue simply git push, that's all. Now you can find I didn't specify anything. Simply I specify git push command. Now it will do the object. Here it will push the content to the repository central a.git. And from branches, from master branch to master branch, it will move a file there. It will move a particular file there. Okay. So now let me move back. Where we are now? Currently we are under the RAM repo. To move back to the central a.git, so I simply type cd dot dot. Change directory, one position backward. Okay. Here, if you type ls, it won't list you. You can find f1.java, but if you type git log, here the log that it is associated will be shown here. File f1.java that is created, this log information will be listed. Okay, before pushing, if I issue a git log, it shows your current branch does not have any commit. Yes, therefore I moved it to the RAM repository. Here I can find f1.java. Okay, so here this f1.java won't be listed under the master repository. If you type ls, it won't list f1.java before and after pushing. Now I move to the RAM repository. I simply issue a git push command. This push command from the master branch of RAM repository, it moves the associated content into the master branch of your central a.git. Okay, now I move back to the central a.git by simply issuing cd dot dot. And if you type ls, even the information f1.java information has been moved, the file won't be listed here. Okay, if I issue a git log, you can find the same log status that it is displayed in your RAM repository. Now you have the central a.git containing information. The information is same in central a.git git log. It will show cd dot dot. Now you are cd, I want to move to the cd RAM repo. Here too I issue the same git log command. Okay, the same log content is going to be same. Now this git log information is associated with central A. It contains the following commit id. The same commit id you can have into the RAM repository. This is the way by which you have the metadata informations moved from one repository into the other repository by issuing a git push command. Now I can create a JP repository from central repository. Okay, so JP repository is a new repository. How I can create? So here, move back. Here itself I can create. My present working directory is under central a.git, under which also I can create, else I can create as a new repository. Okay, so what I need to issue, the command is git clone. I want to issue the source repository. Here I am going to take this central a.git as a source. I am going to create JP repo. Cloning into the JP repo. Now if you type ls, now you can find you have a new folder created as JP repo. If I move to the JP repo, and you can find here you have f1.java is present here. Yes, f1.java. If you type this git log, you can find the same log, f1.java create. Yes, what I did here, based upon the central repository, I have created a new repository for the developer JP. B, the central repository contains f.java. The new repository, JP repository, also now have f.java. Actually, f.java was created by RAM and it is stored under the RAM repository. From RAM repository, this content has been moved from the RAM repository into central a.git, and from central a.git it is moved into the f1.java. Now if you create f2.java in JP repository and if you issue this git push command, then the f2.java will be moved into the central a.git. If you create another repository, based upon that, if you create another repository, here let me assume Amar repo. Okay, based upon this central a.git, now Amar repo, when it is created, will contain f1.java and f2.java. Please make a note. Yes, these are all the ways by which you can create the repository based upon this central repository. Take this scenario, I will do the associated practicals. Do you have any doubt, guys? Please. Yes or no, please. Can I get a response from you all? Either by chat, Amaresh, JP, Mani, Muthu.
Fine. Thank you.
Venu.
Sir, how that git push by simple git push, how it went to central a.git without giving?
What? That is the nature of the command. Git push is the command which do the thing. By the way, it is configured. I know. The padam adhukaga dhaan ungalukku podren. Idhukku munnadi podren paarunga. Endha source la irundhu create pannudho, adhu dhaan adhukku master. Idhukku munnadi potta padatha adhunala dhaan ungala please நீங்க மைண்ட்ல ஒன்று செட் பண்ணிட்டே வச்சிருக்கீங்க, நோட்ஸ் தான் வேணும்னு சொல்லிட்டு நோட்ஸ் தானே, தப்பு கிடையாது. இந்த படத்தை போட்டு உங்களுக்கு எக்ஸ்பிளைன் பண்ண, அதுதான் நீங்க அதை அதை கொஞ்சம் கேர்ஃபுல்லா நீங்க அப்சர்வ் பண்ணீங்கன்னா உங்களுக்கு அந்த கிளாரிட்டி டவுட் வராது. இப்ப நீங்க இந்த ரெபாசிட்டரி எங்கிருந்து கிரியேட் பண்றோமோ அந்த இதுக்கு கிட் புஷ் அப்படிங்கிற கமாண்ட் என்ன பண்ணும், இட் வில் டேக் டு தட் பர்டிகுலர். நம்ம வந்து இந்த சென்ட்ரல் ஏ டாட் கிட்ல இருந்து நம்ம பண்ணனால கிட் புஷ் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கா அதுக்கு போயிடும். நீங்க அதை கொடுக்கணும்னு தேவை கிடையாது, ஆப்ஷன் நீங்க வந்து நீங்க எங்க போகணும்னு கொடுக்கணும்னு தேவை கிடையாது. கிட் புஷ் அப்படின்னு கொடுத்துட்டீங்கனாலே அதனோட சோர்ஸ் எங்க இருந்து கிரியேட் பண்ணப்பட்டதோ அந்த ரெபாசிட்டரிக்கு ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கா புஷ் பண்ணிடும். இப்ப நீங்க அந்த ராமன் ரெப்போ இஸ் கிரியேட்டட் ஃப்ரம் சென்ட்ரல் ஏ அப்படிங்கறதுனால அதுக்கு ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கா சென்ட்ரல் ஏல போய் புஷ் கிட் புஷ் கொடுத்தா போதும். வேற எதுவும் நீங்க அதை ஆப்ஷன் கொடுக்கணும் தேவை, ஆர்குமெண்ட் கொடுக்கணும் தேவை.
ஓகே.
Okay, I will do the practical now. இப்ப என்ன பண்ணிருக்கோம், இப்போ now we are under the JP repo. Okay, we are under the JP repo. Here the JP, now all the repo, central A, RAM repo and JP repo containing only one file, f1.java தான் இருக்கு சரிங்களா. இப்ப JP ல போய் so I am going to create a new file f2.java and I am going to push the file into the central a.java. So I can pull the file from, if the file need to be present in the RAM repository, I can pull the file from central a.git. When I pull the file, the f2.java will be into the RAM repository. Okay, now let I do this. I am going this. Currently my present working directory is JP repo. I have only one file, f1.java. We can verify. I move back, I move to the central repo. Now I can't list this file. If you type ls, it won't list the file. But if you type git log, now you can find the log information, file 1.java. Similarly, you move to the RAM repo. Here in RAM repo also, you have 1.java. Okay. In JP repository, you have file 1.java. In central repository, you have file 1.java. Under RAM repo, to move to the RAM repo, you have 1.java. Now what I am going to do? Let I create a file. Okay, from the JP repo, I create a file f2.java. So move back cd dot dot, here cd JP repository. Now I am in JP repository. Let I create a file here. Touch f2.java. Now if you type ls, now you can find f2.java. git status, the file was found to be untracked file. Git add f2.java. now after that, git commit -m, you want to type the commit message, f2.java created, f2.java created. Yes. Now if you type a git log, now you can find two logs. You can get this git log. Now initial log f1.java and f2.java. These are all the two logs and we have two files here. Okay, where I am currently? I am under the JP repo. If I issue a git push command, git push, automatically what happened here is it will move the file from JP repo. This f2.java will be moved from the JP repo, okay, into the central repo. Here you can find f2.java in central repo. Okay, so before pushing into that, let I verify whether it is present here or not. So here I am under JP repo, move to central repo. Here you can find git log, you can find only one log. Okay, now move to JP repo, git log. Now you can find there are two logs. These two logs will be shown that once you issue the git push command, git push. Now it moved the object from master to master. Okay, so now move back to the central A. Now if I type git log, now you can find both the logs, f1.java and f2.java has been created. but this information is not present in the RAM repo. If you move to the RAM repo, if you type git log, it shows only one log. So RAM containing only f1.java. If RAM wants that file, you need to issue a git pull command. You can find when RAM issue a git pull command, what happens is it will connect the git pull command. It will connect with the issue a git pull command. So automatically the RAM connect with the central repository and looks for any new file. Yes, the central repository containing f2.java. It will pull the file and it will place the file f2.java into the RAM. Now we can find it is connecting with the repository, it is central A, then it is downloading f2.java from central A and it will be placed here. Okay, now f2.java is now present in the RAM repo. So before that, in the RAM repo, if I issue a RAM repo into the RAM repo, so here if we issue the git log, now you can find only f1.java is created. After pushing into the RAM repo, if I type ls, now you can find both the file is present, f1.java and f2.java, both file has been present here. My git log will also show you both the file. Yes, is it clear now what I did so far?